What's up, everybody? It's your boy Q. Back! Woo! Don't do it to him, Q. Don't do it to him, Q. What's up, everybody? I'm back, baby, with another video. What we got going on here? Clusterfuck. I want to make this video about how much I paid for my BMW S1000 2016 Premium Edition, right? So, I'm doing this right now because I got brand new tires on this bike, guys. Like, brand new. Probably got like 10 miles on them. I want to make this video. I did one on my truck, how much I paid for my truck, how much it was, and all that. So I thought I'd do one on the BMW as well, for you guys wanting to know how much it may cost. Woo, shit! Yes, sir! This bike feels stronger for some reason, man. Woo. Man, let me get back over to the solar light, though. How much I paid for my BMW? So I'll go ahead and tell y'all the numbers here. And my man ZSN Mez did a video on this on his 2021 Kawasaki. So if you're interested in that, brand new bike compared to a used bike, you're going to be shocked. Y'all go check him out. I'll put it right there for y'all. Before we talk about how much the bike costs per month, let's talk about insurance. So my insurance on this bike is full coverage, I think $500 deductible through Geico, $66 a month. So it's a little over $600 every 6 months, something like that. So about $66 a month. And I have all our cars, my wife, my truck, and my motorcycle, all through Geico. So that's what I'm looking at as far as insurance. You're a young guy watching this video. My friend's brother was about to buy this bike from me when I had it for sale. He's 18 or 19 years old. The insurance for him per year was $4,000 a year for him to own a BMW S1000. That's what the insurance company quoted him. And that's ridiculous. But that's, so young guys, if you try to go get a 1,000cc bike, you're young, it's gonna hit you in the ass on insurance because you're young, you're wild, and you're free. Which means you're a high goddamn risk to the insurance company that you're probably gonna do something stupid. I also pay for a storage for the bike. I live in an apartment, so I have to pay for a storage. I don't wanna buy the ceiling. That storage costs me $59 a month, $60 a month, basically. And it's kind of pricey, and that's another reason why, you watched my last video, we wanna get a house, because I pay for storage on this thing, $60 a month. Which is kind of, you know, kind of expensive. So I bought this bike in March. Bike was listed at $12,900 or $13,000, something like that. So after tax, I didn't last, you looking at like $15,000 for a 2016 bike, 2016 BMW. It had 8,000 miles on it, 7,000-8,000 miles on it. So it's okay, not a bad deal, right? But these are not exact numbers, guys. So just bear with me. It was $15,000. I was gonna put down $2,000 in cash. When I went to put down $2,000 in cash, it literally came out to a $7 difference, $7 or $12 difference per month. So it was nothing. So I didn't put down any cash. The guy told me, like, hey man, you might as well just keep your cash because it's only gonna change your payments by $7, $7 to $12, and it's not worth it. So I put down $0 on this bike, $0. And I financed, what, the $14,000 to $15,000. My interest rate was like a 5.1. Or 4.7, something like that. And it was, to me, I personally thought that was very high because my truck finance was only, 3.3%, somewhere in there. So it's very, very high compared to my truck. And I asked him, like, why is it so high? I like, my credit is fine. He said, utility vehicles like these, ATVs, they're always gonna be a higher percentage on the interest because of the type of, what's your finances? It's like a toy, basically what he said. So I'm like, okay. I was gonna say, that's way too high. I'm like, I'm not paying that, you know, that interest rate. So I ended up financing the bike, zero down, at like a 5.3 interest rate for 3 years. That came out to be a monthly payment, $350 a month is what I paid for this bike with zero down at 3 years. At 5 point whatever interest rate. Now if you go to watch Mayor's video, he gave his price. He pays less than this for a brand new bike. My point is, BMWs are just expensive bikes, guys. Like, he got his bike brand new for like, what, 16, 17? My bike used was like 15. It's crazy. So BMW is just expensive. So you're looking to get one, just know they're hella expensive. So keep that in mind. If you add in the total cost of monthly payments for the bike, it's $350. Insurance, which is $66, and the storage was another $60. This bike cost me about what's that, $460, $470 a month just to own this bike. And as there's really nothing I can do to get rid of it. Only thing I can do is save $60 for the store. That's really about it. Everything else it is what it is. I didn't know that utility vehicles are financed at a high rate. You know, it kind of threw me off guard. But hopefully that video helps some of you guys out. How much it costs to own a bike like a BMW or any new bike, you know. All these new bikes are going up in price because they're getting more expensive, they're getting faster, more tech, all that. So just keep that in mind. I'm about to go have some fun. I'll catch y'all in the next one. Peace.